the ALICE networks. So the ALICE network is a European Excellence Network on Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning. It consists of different memberships on the personal side and also memberships in terms of units that one can apply for. And in total, we have at the moment 41 units over all Europe. You see on the left a small map where these units are located, and one is the ALICE unit Jena. And we have also, that's important for hiring new scientists, young PhD students, we have a PhD program in the ALICE where we received for the 24 year more than 3,000 applicants from all over the world, excellent people, and we are at the moment currently selecting those people. The coordinator of this network, this excellent network at the European level, is located in Tübingen, and our unit consists at the moment at 9 members, 7 associate members, and what is also important, we already received 3 PhD students in the ALICE program, which is a very competitive program, and I am happy that these people bring the ALICE unit forward. What is the ALICE unit Jena about? It's about ML-enabled understanding of spatial temporal Earth systems, and you see here on the one axis of this map, the methods that we are going to develop. That's anomaly detection, early warning. We also develop methods in dynamic now and forecasting, and in the end also data assimilation and ML-based latent inference. The applications in this area, this knowledge integration, that's what we want to do, based on hybrid modeling, it's a very modern term, causal modeling, which also is done in my group, and in the end, also, of course, in the Earth system science, spatial temporal modeling by state space modeling. Why do I refer to this figure from our proposal for the ALICE unit Jena? It's because in all these sessions that we will see today, we have already these topics represented by other funded projects. That means it's a very important research area, and the goal of today's event is that we want to bring together all these activities and to exchange what are the methods, the right methods to do. But how did we arrive at this point and also at today? Well, it's a result of sustainable research activities and funding over almost the past 10 years. So we started with a project funded by the Thuringian government, COSRE. I'm quite sure that none of you know this project, or at least only a few. And then we founded in 2015 the Michael Stiefel Center Jena at the Friedrich Schiller University Jena. And this led to the first funded project by the Carl Zeiss Foundation in the area of AI, this, the workshop on digitalization in the sciences, Werkstatt für die Digitalisierung in den Wissenschaften. And together with these activities that we have been part of the founding activities of the DLR Institute for Data Science in Jena, and we also found an institute, the Thuringian Center for Learning Systems and Robotics, that has the goal to bring these activities to industry, the AI activities. And in the end, you see here on the topmost side in 22, we got the funding from the Carl Zeiss Foundation and the Friedrich Schiller University Jena to apply for the ALICE unit in the ALICE network, and we received this unit from the ALICE community. And but that was not the end. So after that, we already had connected to a lot of different activities here in Jena. So what you see here is that we are part of the CERC in Jena, the Center for Mental Health, the German Center for Mental Health. We also are part of an activity together with University of Leipzig on breathing nature. Yeah, this is also an activity that came from the ALICE unit activities. And in the end also, finally, a project together with the medical people that we will hear today also about using machine learning and knowledge integration into machine learning to support surgeries for tumor resection. And in the end, we also are active in more political outreach. So we are part of the AI for Good network. We have a seminar series there. And what we recently did 1 week ago, we have the opportunity to be part of the Digital Summit in Jena, where we organized a session about artificial intelligence for resilience and early warning in climate change. And this shows that the activity of the LSU in Jena is not just science, it's also transferred to industry and recently also, and very more importantly, to bring these developments to society and politics.